Hello everyone and welcome to Nissa's Kitchen. Today I'm making chickpea and rice pilaf. If you like this recipe, then please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel. So let's get started. To make this recipe, I'm going to begin by heating up some oil in a pan. And to that oil, I'm going to add some cumin seeds. Now, I ended up adding too many cumin seeds because I was trying to focus on the camera at the same time. But you can, by all means, add a little less. I'm going to cook the cumin seeds until they're fragrant, and then I'm going to add the onions. Onion, I'm going to cook until they become translucent and are getting a little golden brown. After that, I'm going to add my chickpeas. Now, I always have chickpeas handy because I boil them and then I put them in a Ziploc bag and I freeze them. So whenever I need them, I can just take them out, run them through a hot water, and they're good to go. You can use canned chickpeas as well. I just don't like canned chickpeas because anything canned makes me sick. I believe they use preservatives or something, but I get really, really sick, so I avoid doing that. Once they're mixed with the onion and the cumin seeds, I'm going to add my rice. The rice I had washed and I had them soaking for about half an hour in lukewarm water. So you can directly put rice in the pan as well. That would work as well, but I had them soaking beforehand. And then I'm going to add the water. Now be careful guys, the water that you add is the water the rice is going to cook in. So there is you can't add too much water. So like I showed you, the first line of your finger is where the water should be, and the tip of your finger should be touching the rice. And that's the trick my mom uses to measure the water level. That's the trick I'm learning. I'm still learning. Sometimes I get a little too much or a little less of water, but this trick works every time. So that's where what it should be. And then I'm going to cook it on high heat until the water evaporates. I like to mix it in periodically and then let the bubbles come in as the water cooks. You don't have to mix it in. My mom never mixes the rice while it's cooking. I just like doing that because I find that the rice sticks together less if I mix it like that way. So I will let it cook on high heat until the bubbles have dried up, almost dried up, somewhat like here. And then I'm going to turn the heat almost to minimum, and I will cover it and let it cook for a few minutes. For a few minutes, I'm going to uncover it, and the rice you will see is completely cooked. I will also turn off the stove, and then I will show you how soft the rice is. You can serve it with yogurt, you can serve it with curry. It's a crowd pleaser, very easy to make. Your family will love it, your guests will love it. If you have unexpected guests, you can make this. I'm going to enjoy it with some curry, and let me know how you like this recipe, guys. If you liked it, please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon so you don't miss any other episodes. Until next time, take care.